Hi everyone, welcome back to $10 Garden Series Season 2. Well, today we're going to talk about growing carrots. Hopefully by now most of you have gotten your seeds started indoors, you're seeing them germinate and are having a great time. If you haven't yet, go back and watch the first two videos and just jump in with us. Well, one of the seeds we haven't started yet from the $10 Garden Seed Kit are carrots. Now, I'm going to show you how to get them going today in a container so that when it does get warm enough wherever you live, you can bring them outdoors and they'll already be growing for you. So let's get started. Now, carrots are such a fun crop to grow, especially for kids. They love coming outside, growing them and harvesting them and eating them right in the garden. They grow especially well in containers because they're a root vegetable and they really like the loose soil. We just harvested these beautiful Danvers carrots from this container this morning. And one reason why carrots grow so well in a container is because the container soil is nice and loose, which helps the carrots grow straight so they don't get that funny misshapen look. Now you can see in here, I've got a couple more that are ready to harvest, but I'm gonna leave them in and not harvest them because the great thing about carrots is too, you can just harvest them as you need them. The first thing you're going to need is a container. I'm growing my carrots in a 5-gallon Smart Pots fabric container, which works really well. It's a perfect size for growing carrots. Now you can certainly add any kind of bagged organic potting mix that you want, but today I'm going to do my little DIY potting mix. So the first thing I'm going to add to it is coco coir. Now if you've never used coco coir before, it's a really nice medium to add to your potting mix. This one is hydrated here, but it comes in a little brick like this, or you can buy it in a big, large size, but the small brick works really well for small containers. So I'm gonna add one part coco coir to one part vermiculite. And this is the vermiculite here. It's just kinda adds some aeration to the soil. And then you wanna add two parts of compost. Now I am using a bagged compost just because my own compost is not quite ready yet to add to my potting mix. So we'll add two parts of compost. And a part can be whatever you want. I just happen to be using this old little scoop right here. Then I also like to add some worm castings. And these are the Vermistera worm castings that we did the worm casting video on a few weeks ago. And I'm gonna add a couple of scoops of that. Now I am gonna add some more potting mix here so this container is completely filled, but I just wanted to show you the proportions first. So I've got our container, our scoop of worm castings. Then of course we gotta add some nice organic fertilizer. We're gonna put the Trifecta Plus in here. Just gonna give these carrots some really nice nutrients. So they're very productive. These are nice big carrots. So we'll add a couple of scoops. And that's probably about a half a cup or so. And then I'm gonna add a bunch more of that to this container to get it all filled up. The soil is nice and light and fluffy, which is perfect for starting carrots, but we want to get this mix watered down. So it's nice and pre-moistened when we add our seeds. You just repeat those steps until the container that you're using is full. Now you can definitely grow carrots in a smaller container. This one is about a foot tall, and it really is about an ideal height for this particular type of carrot because you can see the carrot's gonna grow down here and you want there to be enough room for the roots. So these are the Danvers carrots from the $10 Garden Seed Kit, and carrot seeds are super tiny. Show you what they look like here. And you just wanna take a few seeds, pinch them in between your fingers and drop in a few seeds about an inch or so apart. Now I'm going to go in a little spiral shape around this container. And don't worry if you get a few extra seeds in there because we'll go back and thin these carrots as they grow. Now that I have my carrot seeds planted, I'm going to cover them very, very lightly with a little bit more of my DIY potting mix. Now I don't want to put too much on here, or the carrots will have a hard time sprouting. Now we're gonna give these carrot seeds a light little dose of water. You can spray it very lightly with a spray bottle also. The important thing about growing carrots is you have to keep the soil moist, especially while they're germinating, so you do not want these to dry out. So give them a nice little mist each day, and before you know it, probably in about 5 to 7 days, you're gonna have these carrots sprouting and germinating. It's gonna be super exciting to see them grow. If you live somewhere where it's already warm outside and the danger of frost is gone, you can put your carrots outside and they'll grow really nicely for you. But if you live somewhere where it's still cold, you want to grow these inside until the danger of frost is gone. So you're definitely going to need some kind of indoor grow light. Now, some of you, I'm sure your grow light box by now is getting pretty full. So let me show you another really super easy indoor grow light setup. This is a super simple, quick, inexpensive grow light setup. It's just a 1/2 gallon jug filled about halfway full with sand, a PVC pipe, a clip light, and a special grow light bulb. Now you want to put your grow light just about 2 inches from your soil. That way, as soon as your seedlings germinate, they'll be hit with the light, and that way the stems won't get leggy and they'll be nice and strong. Now I'm going to leave this on for 18 hours a day. And this is such a great setup because you can put it on a tabletop or stick it in a corner of your dining room. It really works well for growing indoors. If you need seeds for your spring garden, make sure you check out the $10 Garden Seed Kit. Easy to grow varieties for a very affordable price. And all the other supplies I use in this video will be linked up in the video description. Get some carrot seeds going today because before you know it, you'll have some of your own fresh, tasty, delicious carrots to eat right from your own backyard. Oh, these smell so good. Well, comment below. Let me know how your spring garden is doing. If you have any questions, I'd love to help you answer them. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.